Hi, I'm Bev from Panda Owl Weddings and Events, and I have teamed up with the guys at Get Knotted to bring you some inside advice when it comes to planning your big day. Over this series, we're going to be talking to some different suppliers, we're going to be looking at different venues and helping you get the most out of your planning and the best ways to make sure that you have the best day possible. Today we're in Brighton and we're going to be going around and we're going to be looking at some local venues and some of your options. We're going to be talking about what sort of things to ask a venue and what's included in your price. And we're also going to start to look at why having a wedding coordinator can help make your day the best day possible.
Get ready, cause here I come.
We are in historic Brighton, one of the most iconic seaside towns in the UK. Brighton is a perfect backdrop for any kind of wedding, and today we will be looking at Angel House, a fully restored Grade 1 listed building. Let's go take a look inside. Room that you come into at Angel House is the morning room. Now when you walk into a venue, you need to instantly feel something about it. So if you walk in and it doesn't make you go wow, it's maybe not the right venue for you. What's lovely about Angel House is this room is just part of what you're hiring. This room can be used for your canapes, for your drinks, or your in-between bits while you're having photos and things done. So you'll still get a lovely room while they're waiting for you to have photos and everything done. Let's go and have a look at the main ceremony room itself as well. This is the main Regency room. In this room, you'll have your ceremony, you have your dinner with all your guests, and then your evening reception with your live music if that's what you choose to do. Now, Angel House is possibly the only venue on the South Coast that has the beautiful uninterrupted sea views that you can see here. So you can stand, take your vows over the sea, be warm and cozy in a beautiful building with beautiful architecture. So now we're going to have a quick chat about what are the main things to look for when you're booking a venue. So for example, with a venue like this, it is a Grade 1, very old building, there's no disabled access, so you won't have any wheelchairs or anything upstairs. So that's something to make sure that you ask about and to be clear with if you do have anyone that's going to require that kind of access. Secondly, you need to check your minimum and maximum capacities for every room. Some companies will have a minimum people that you have to have, and a lot will definitely have a maximum capacity, which is more for your comfort than for anything else. So the final room we're going to be looking at Angel House here today is what we like to call the best bedroom. It's pretty hard not to agree. This room has most of the original Regency features and is a wonderful treat for your first night as a married couple. Now when booking any venue, accommodation is key, so you need to make sure if there's any local hotels that your venue that you choose are linked with, if they do any discounts if you're in a hotel yourself, or what's the better way to make sure that your guests have a comfortable stay if they're travelling down from a long way. So how do you find the venue that's right for you? Most people start with a Google search, which is great as a starting point, but it's a very vast amount of venues that you could be looking for over a very vast area. You also have no way of knowing if that venue is of any good at all. So the best thing to do is either grab yourself a wedding coordinator who will already have links with venues or can do that searching and verifying for you, or you can go to a verified site like getknotted and they will already have vetted and checked out the venues to make sure that they're going to be delivering you a great service. If you want to know more about finding a venue or have any questions at all, please do email me on the email address below. Links are also below in the comments and descriptions.
So now you know how to find your venue. Join us next time when we look at the ceremony and all the different ways that you can say, I do.